Hi guys and ladies, welcome back to another exciting episode of Being an Analyst. This is episode number 34. My name is Disemba Matsietsi. My aim is to share all that I could with my almost 2 decades experience in banking and having 7 university qualifications. 3 of those are from the best, 3 of the best business schools in South Africa, GSB, Gibbs and Henley. And my aim is, if you really, really want to turn data into insights and take them to the boardroom, I'm here to share all of that knowledge with you. My skills are from strategy analysis, business analysis, finance analysis, and also looking at sales analysis, you name it. I'm here to make sure that you are able to know what you can do to take your skills or your career further. And with that said, in this episode, we are discussing online tools and training that you can use to actually kickstart your career in analysis, especially starting from being just a novice, taking it all the way to being really, really good. We're going to be looking at tools and documentation that you can use online, 6 of those that you can use online to take your career from novice to being an expert in data analysis. All of that is coming through just after our theme song, so stay tuned. As we're discussing online courses and tutorials that you can use to actually take your career forward, most of us are asking, is it still relevant to go to university? Well, for this episode, that's not what we are answering. What we're answering is, if you're taking the route to actually go online and try the online route to say, I'm gonna go do not so expensive tools and certifications online, and I'm gonna try to convert all that I will get online into a data analysis or an analyst career. We're trying to look at which of the 6 can you actually take. 6 of the online courses, they're available there. Some of those are available free on trial and in month 2 you start to pay. Some are available free forever. We're just looking at 6 of those that you can start. And what's more important is, what are you going to be learning that you can put onto your CV, or that you can tell them when you go for an interview to say, listen, I know these skills. So number 1 on the list, let's start right there. Number 1 on the list is the IBM Introduction to Data Analysis. IBM's Introduction to Data Analysis. IBM has started this for quite a while. And you used to get all of this from IBM website, but now they've put it on Coursera. So if you have a Coursera license, it looks like it might be a good license for the list that I'm going to come up with. So the first one, it's on Coursera. What they aim to teach you, what they aim to give you as a skill is the following. When you do this course, it's only 10 hours. Only 10 hours to do. You can do it 2 hours a day, 5 days, 5 work week, 5 days. If you just take your lunch break and just an extra hour, and then you do these courses, after 5 days, you'll be compliant in this one. And you'll be able to know the following. You'll be able to write data science on your CV, well, introduction to data science. You'll be able to write spreadsheet on your CV. You'll be able to write data analysis on your CV. You'll be able to write Microsoft Excel on your CV, and you'll be able to write data visualization on your CV. So those are the 5 skills that you can put on your CV when you do this course immediately. What they promise that you will learn after this week is you'll be able to explain what data analysis is and the key steps that you must take in data analytics process. So everything else follows a process. All of us, You know, we might be bright, but we know that there's processes, frameworks, and tools that you have to go through. So there's a data analysis process. All you have to do is, once you go through the data analysis process, you'll be able to know about that, and you can be able to share that with your prospective employer or team that you're willing to share. You'll be able to differentiate between different data roles, such as data engineer, data analysis, data science, business analyst, and business intelligence analyst. We've spoken about these roles earlier on earlier episode. I think it was in episode number 8, episode number 9. If you feel like you need a refresher on the roles, you can still go to those and then just listen out to the how do we differentiate between these roles. You'll be able to describe the different types of data structures. I think that's what we cover. If you have the book, if you have one of the book that I managed to pen, being an analyst, you'll be able to learn about data structures, file formats, and sources of data. It's either you do it over there or you get it in here on the book. And the book here, it's only one chapter. But in the course, it is 10 hours of going through. So you can read my book within 2 hours. Just to get a gist of things. And you can do the course within 10 hours. You can't take the 10 hours down because it's one video after another. So the 10 hours is there. The last thing that they promise that you will learn, you'll be able to describe the data analysis process involving the collection, wrangling, mining, and visualization of data. On the book, on my book, Being an Analyst, Unleashing Managing Yourself for Success and Unleashing Your Potential in the Knowledge Economy, I normally put that on chapter 4 as part of the data science and business analysis, chapter 4 and chapter 5, just to say what is data wrangling, what is. So more or less, you'll still be on the right path. This course will provide you with a solid foundation for understanding data analytics and its implications. That just, if you were wondering, this is called IBM's Introduction to Data Analytics. It's on Coursera, so you can go right now to Coursera and then have a look at that course. The second course that you can take, if you feel like this one, the first one is a little bit light, the second one that you can take is Google's Data Analytics. It's also on Coursera, but I must tell you that this one, because it's so intense, it takes 6 months. It takes 6 months of dedicated work. You're going to be putting in a few hours. Let's say you put in 7 to 10 hours every week, it'll take you 6 months to finish it up. If you are tight, your budget is very, very tight, you need to think about this one before you click on it. Even though they have scholarship of funding available, meaning that they can reduce the cost, 6 months is really a bit longer. You might have to pay 1 or 2 months full subscription of Coursera. The skills that you will gain because it's 6 months, you'll be able to write a lot of things on your CV. You'll be able to write data analysis, of course, creating case studies. You'll be able to write data visualization, be able to write data cleansing, developing a portfolio, data collection, spreadsheets, metadata, SQL or SQL, data ethics, data aggregation, data calculations, R Markdown, R Programming, R Studio, Tableau software, presentation, data integrity, sample size determination, decision making, problem solving, and questioning. Why? Because it takes you 6 months. Every week, you'll be learning one of the skills and you'll be going forward to that. So this one, really, really, if you really, really know that you really, really want to become a data analyst, I would say go for it, because it's a 6 months long investment. If you are busy at work and you cannot find the 10 hours a week, this might actually extend to a year. It might extend to a year long course that you have to take. They promise that at the end of the 6 months, you'll be able to gain an immense understanding of the practices and processes used by a junior or associate data analyst in their day-to-day job. So it will help you to land an entry-level data analysis role. You will learn key analytical skills such as data cleaning, analysis, and visualization. And tools such as spreadsheets, R programming, SQL and Tableau, and all of these things are required from a junior data analyst or just an associate data analyst. You will also be able to understand how to clean and organize data for analysis and complete analysis and calculation using spreadsheets, SQL and R programming. So you'll learn how to visualize and present data findings on dashboards, presentation, and commonly used on visualization platforms. We can call it Power BI, you can be Tableau. You'll be able to do that. What is nice about this Google certificate is that most people know about it and they know the value that you'll be bringing to the team. So they know that they don't have to teach you from scratch all of this. They can just teach you how the organization operates. Because when you go to any organization, you still need to learn how the organization operates. So 6 months, you'll be able to explore the power of data. You'll learn statistical tools and visualize data for effective decision making. That's if you have 6 months on Coursera. 6 months, you'll come out with a new skill. You are on fire. Number three that we're going to be looking at is called the IBM Data Analysis with Python. Not just data analysis only, but this one comes with Python. It reminds me of SpongeBob and Mr. Krabs saying, SpongeBob with cheese, SpongeBob with cheese. So this is not just data analysis. This one comes with Python. So it comes with a huge snake, Python. So what they promise on this one is also available on Coursera. So if you have a Coursera license, it looks like you'll be able to get the best out of it. Why? Coursera is actually, you know, developed itself as a nice platform and is trusted by most organizations. We have seen now by Google and IBM and them to host their online, you know, training. Yes, it's for a fee because you pay for the subscription, but they're able to manage all of that for the organization quite well. And that's why almost everything else is Coursera. You don't get them in Google and IBM websites anymore. What you will be able to write on your CV if you do IBM's data analysis with Python, you will be able to write the following. You'll be able to say model selection. You'll be able to write data analysis. You'll be able to write Python programming. You'll be able to write data visualization and predictive modeling. Once you are done with this, you'll be able to do predictive modeling. Wow, isn't that wonderful? What they promise you will learn at the end of this course, which is just a few weeks, it's supposed to take 15 hours. So let's call it 2 weeks. Just at the end of 2 weeks with doing 2 hours a day. At the end of 2 weeks or at the end of this 15 hours, they promise that you will be able to develop Python code for cleaning and preparing data for analysis, which includes the handling of missing values, formatting, normalizing, and binding data. If you've worked with data, you would know that this is one of the major problems. Missing information, it's a problem. But luckily, there is a data science tool for that to say omit missing data without affecting the data itself. Like, so for instance, if we have 5 observations, and only 4 has got numbers on it. If I do aggregate, it aggregates not on 4, but it aggregates on 5. You have to manually take out 1. But when it comes to big data or data science, I mean, you would not know which one has got missing data or unqualified data, but the algorithm will be able to take out the ones with missing data or not with the right data to make sure that only the ones with the qualifying data are seen, but the average is not being affected, which is very, very important. You don't want the people upstairs making the decisions on the wrong thing because you're missing 1 or 2 things. You'll be able to perform exploratory data analysis. Exploratory is where you're understanding what's inside your data, just going around to check out the data. Exploratory data analysis. And you will apply analytical techniques to read world data sets using libraries such as Panda, NamFi, and SciFi. You'll be able to manipulate data using data frames. You'll summarize data. You'll understand data. You'll distribute. You understand data distribution, and you will perform correlation and create data pipelines. Once you are done with this one, just in 2 weeks, you'll be able to do this, and you'll be able to build and evaluate regression models using machine learning, whether it's SkyKit, Learn, Library, and use them for predictive and decision making. What's nice about this, it allows you to dive into Python-based data analysis techniques and gain practical skills or practical analysis. I must say what they wrote here, when I did my honors, it took me 6 months to have a background on, you know, what is big data, what we should do. I can't say only if these tools were available back then in 2016. But all I could say is this would help quite plenty than the theory that I had to go through and then just come up with one project that was, it still missed the mark according to me now. So I would say for me, 1 week of 1 or 2 weeks of this data analysis with Python will actually put you in a better position than I was after 6 months of university. I'm not bashing university. I love university. I got too many degrees. I have to love university. Let's go to the fourth one. The fourth one is introduction to data analysis using Microsoft Excel. Yes, I would not stop without including Excel. So this one is also on Coursera. It's introduction to data analysis using Microsoft Excel. What you will be able to write on your CV is the following. It's lookup table, it's data analysis, it's Microsoft Excel, it's pivot table. It's important that you write these keywords because when you are looking for a job, they are looking for those keywords when they search if you're an appropriate candidate or not. So it's important that you write those keywords, exactly those keywords on your CV. So this one, it's actually quite long because they're giving you 7 hours a week. So it will take you about 4 weeks. So a month, when you start whole full month, you'll be able to finish up the course. On week one, you'll be doing introduction to spreadsheets. This module will be, them introducing you to just how to use Excel spreadsheets and various basic functions that you can use, sum, aggregate, just introduction. On week two, this is where stuff will start to heat up a little bit. This is where you start to use the functions of a spreadsheet so that you can know the functions and how to organize some data. This module includes various Excel functions to organize and query data. If you enroll on this course, you will be introduced to the if statement and nested if, meaning that you have an if statement and inside another if statement, another if statement. So if this happens, if this happened, if that happened, it's a nested if statement. You'll be able to do VLOOKUPs and HLOOKUPs functions and all of those lookups in Excel. So that's what they'll be introducing you to. On week number three, you'll be doing filtering now. So it will take you to introduction of filters and as well as pivot tables and charts. So you're starting to heat up a little bit now because now you're on a different realm. So this will introduce you to various filtering capabilities on Excel. You'll learn how to set filters in data or selectively access data so that you put on slicers on top to say, no, I don't want all the data, I only want this, that, that. A very powerful data summarizing tool. The pivot table is also explained and we begin to introduce the charting feature on Excel. So you can be able to create a chart and a pivot table and they are linked. When you select something on pivot table, the chart shows you immediately, which is quite nice if you're a busy exec probably and you just want to click on a few things and visualize them immediately. It works quite well. Week number four, you'll be doing advanced graphing and charting. This is when you'll explore various advanced graphing and charting techniques available in Excel. You'll start with various lines, line graphs, pie charts, while introduce pivot charts, scatter plots, and histograms. You will get the understanding of these various charts and get to build them on your own, which is quite important. Building everything else on your own is a very, very important part. So that's number four. Let's go to number five. Number five is the business analytics with Excel. Yes, I told you, I love Excel. This one is to help you start from, they say, elementary to advanced. It's presented by the John Hobson University. This is beautiful because not just will you be able to write the following on your CV: modeling, spreadsheet, Microsoft Excel, business analytics, and solver. What's beautiful about this one is that it's made out of not four modules, but six modules. So a little bit more intense. And if you want to do this one, I would suggest you start with the previous one first, with the one we set on number four, which is the introduction to data analysis using Microsoft Excel. The one that's guided, you know, you are guided on Coursera. This one that says business analytics with Excel, much more intense, because this is what you're going to be doing. Week one, you're going to be doing introduction to Excel. Okay. Yes, you think that is the same as the introduction on the other side, but it differs a little bit. So here you're doing just the basic. After the basics, then you do the best practices. After you get the best practices, then you can jump into module two. On module two, you start to do what if analysis, which is quite tricky. What if analysis is very tricky. You can do that one, introduction and what if analysis, on week one. And then on week number two, you do two modules, which is decision analysis through regression and net present value, NPV. You can do that one on week number two. And you can also do linear programming, which is another module, on week number two. So each week you can actually do two modules, making it very, very intense, because these things are quite linear programming and decision analysis is not quite easy. It's very intense. This course, it covers Excel-based business analytics from basic to advanced level. So you can just see here, you start with basics, you go what if analysis, you go decision analysis through regression and net present value, you go linear programming, and then you do transportation and assignment problems. After that, you do integer programming and nonlinear programming. All of these are hectic, but with 1 month, you can be able to do all of this thing. Nice part about it is you are able to do all of these things using Excel. Isn't that wonderful, using Excel? Because some of us, we know Excel, and then when you come over, you're like, do R, do whatever program, we get frozen, like, I don't know how to use that R. But in this case, you'll be able to do all of these things in Excel, which is quite important. Very, very nice for us. The number six tool that we can explore and talk about, it's made by Google. It's called Data Analysis with R Programming. Data analysis with R programming. Very, very nice. The skills that you're going to gain on this one is just simple. You are going to gain data analysis. The only thing else that you can put on this one when you do data analysis with R programming is just simple, data analysis. It takes 34 hours approximately to do. So if you're doing 10 hours a week, this is 3 weeks. If you're doing 5 hours a week, this is 6 weeks. You do your own pace. You know, Coursera is happy. She's happy to collect the money every month. But you pace it your own way. But if you do this one, this is where you really, really want to. Instead of the previous one where we did with Excel, this is where you say, I want to do it with R programming. So you'll be programming on R. What you will learn, you are promised that you'll be able to describe the R programming language and its programming environment. R, very fascinating. But if you are very new to R and you don't know all those concepts, it can take you all over the show. If you already know Excel, you know Microsoft SQL, you've played around with a few tools. When you get to R, then you're like, oh, okay, this is how you do that. Oh, this is how you do this. Starting from scratch, I don't know, I haven't experienced it. I'm just thinking you might have to, you know, struggle a little bit, but there's nothing that cannot do. You'll probably do very well. So you'll be able to explain the fundamental concepts associated with programming in R, which includes the functions, the variables, data types, pipes, and vectors. Another thing that you'll be able to do is to describe the options for generating visualizations in R. I know it's got that weird thing that you do like you plot a graph and then the graph just pops up. You have to take it a picture. I don't understand R for that. But anyway, it's beautiful because it does large amount of data and it does correlation. But there's those pops up that pops up all the time. You'll be able to demonstrate an understanding of the basic formatting in R, Markdown, to create structure and emphasize on content. Nice part about it is you'll explore R programming for data analytics tasks. So we gave you the six. I'm not going to bring in a quiz. We gave you the six different courses that you can do to explore online courses and, you know, tutorials that you can do to expand your knowledge. So that's it. So, but before we go on and disappear, remember that these courses just provide a solid foundation, not mastery, just a solid foundation. But practices and real world application are equally important. As you progress, consider working with projects, participate in hackathons, and collaborate with other analysts to hone your skills further. So if you want to learn more about this thing, there's a lot of articles that have been written about the top 10 rules, top 10 tools, top 10 courses that you can take, top 10 this, top 10 that. As far as I'm concerned, those six, this list of this six is the best that you can ever find. Besides that, we have summarized everything else in this beautiful book. I've managed to pen this book. It's called Being an Analyst, Managing Yourself for Success and Unleashing Your Potential. That's what we want to do, especially now in the knowledge economy. So this book is able to take you through all of this. It might not be per course, but it just tells you what's the importance of learning different tools. Not the programming tool itself like R, Python, but what's the importance of learning what is offered by R and Python in your analysis journey. So whether you want to be a qualitative analyst or quantitative analyst, this is the book that will not just help you with your career aspiration, but it is the perfect guide, an essential guide to becoming not just an analyst, but become a catalyst for success and a driver of organizational change. This book is for you. Why am I saying tribe of organizational change? Because as soon as I started to pivot from just knowing about finance and working in finance and starting to say, how does the finance data all come together? I started becoming a good catalyst for organizational change. And that is why in 2016, I was one of those that championed the introduction of Power BI in finance. Today, almost every organization uses Power BI for finance. But back then, I was a catalyst for organizational change. So I hope you also become a catalyst for organizational change, because there's nice tools that are coming out. There's new ways of reporting. There's ways that you can link to organizational strategy. And it becomes even much more exciting. So that is me, Disema Matsietsi, right now on episode number 34. Let's meet again, episode number 35. Stay blessed.